do some reading, some writing, and some math too. Play outside, have a snack, and of course we're at home. We'll have a great day, a great day, a great day today. We'll have a great day, great day, a great day today. All right, good afternoon, boys and girls. I had some technical difficulties this morning, and so I missed getting my video to you this morning, but here I am now. And I have to say, good morning, Sarisa. Hi, Sarisa. Good morning, Abraham. Hi, Abraham. Good morning, Penny. Hello, Penny. Good morning, Felix.
Felix.
Good morning, Amelia. Hi, Amelia. Good morning, Molly. Hi, Molly. Good morning, Danor. Hi, Danor. Good morning, Milo. Hi, Milo. Good morning, Nelson. Hi, Nelson. Good morning, Aiden. Hello, hello. Good morning, Evelyn. Hi, hi. Good morning, Henrik. Hello, hello. Good morning, Mason. Hi, Mason. Good morning, Lewis. Hello, Lewis. And hello again to Henrik. Hi, Henrik. Good morning, Abriana. Hi, Abriana. Good morning, Mawad. And good morning, Noel. Hello, Noel. Good morning, Zainab, all the way again in Pakistan. Good morning to Simon. Hi, Simon. And to Miguel. Hello, Miguel. And to Alondra. Of course, it's not the morning anymore, but I'm still calling this a morning meeting. So I say good morning to you. All right. So today I was thinking, and you're probably already, can you peek behind me and see what's in my truck? Are you wondering today what's in there? You recognize this person. So I'm going to go get the truck and see what's in here today to share. My truck. All right. You guys know this person. Ooh, and it's hard to get her kind of in close, but I'll angle it like this. It's tricky to see. Lots of reflections here. I'll put it down here. That's a little bit easier. And then I'll bring it up so you can see her shoes. Oh, there we go. There's no reflection. All right. All right. On the count of three, we're going to say who this person is. One, two, three. You're right. This is my daughter. This is Anna. And you guys remember when we were doing me math and I brought in Anna's special dance shoes. And I'm going to count to three. See if you can remember what they're called. Ready? One, two, three. Yes, they are called point shoes. And remember, when I take Anna's shoes and I tap them on the ground, they make a really loud sound. And when she dances directly on her toes. And so when Anna dances, Anna has to wear a lot of different shoes. But do I have to wear shoes to dance? No. Do I have to wear socks to dance? No. My feet can dance any single time they want to. Now, a lot of grown-ups, and you can tell me if this is true about your grown-up or not, but a lot of grown-ups kind of feel silly sometimes when they dance. And they feel like, oh my goodness, people are noticing that I look kind of silly, and I feel kind of strange about all this. Whoop, there goes Anna. And that's okay. But here's the kind of cool thing about being in our homes and not having to go anywhere. Can we dance as much as we want? Yeah. And is anybody going to see? No. Just the people in our family. And is it going to feel really good to run around and dance and move? For sure. So you don't need special shoes like Anna has to be able to dance. You can just dance barefoot. You can dance in jammies. You can dance in regular clothes. You can dance outside. You can dance inside. You can dance on carpet. You could even lay on the ground and you could put your feet up in the air and just your feet could dance. So I'm going to play some music and I want you, I'll make little Anna dance here, and then I want you to dance as well. And nobody's watching, so all you're going to do is dance. Let me find my music. Here we go. You ready?
Dance, dance, dance. I hit the floor, good, that's my plans.
you dancing? If you're getting bored at home and you're like, oh my gosh, I can't watch another episode of my little brother watching Paw Patrol. Oh my goodness, I've read all the books in my room. Oh my goodness, I don't know what to do with myself. Find some music and dance. Find some music. You can count the rhythms out. You can clap. You can tap. You can stomp. You can pretend to be a cat dancing. You can pretend to be a mouse dancing. You can pretend if a whale knew what music was and they were in the ocean, you can pretend to move how a whale might move. So that's what I want you to think about today. How can I move my body in my house, in my apartment, in my home? And you know what would be kind of fun? Is you could ask your family, and especially the grown-ups in your family, what kind of dancing they like to do. Maybe they'll show you some moves, or maybe they'll show you some of their favorite music from when they were kids. That's pretty fun because I don't think kids today have always listened to the music that their moms and dads and grammys and grandpas listened to when they were growing up. Pretty fun stuff. All right. Well, in just a couple minutes, I have to go to a staff meeting in my dining room. So on my computer every single day, I have meetings with my kindergarten team and I have other meetings. And then today, all the Aquila teachers are getting together and we go to the